Hey guys, your boy Cabrera, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Marseille career mode. Whoops, where last time left off. I picked up two very convincing wins in the league over Nantes. Still don't know how to say their name correctly, and Lille, whose name I can say correctly, I think. It's probably pronounced something different in French, but in English, it's Lille. Oh, the team that gave the Premier League Eden Hazard and Divock Origi. They were no match for me. As you can see, I'm going back into the Europa League in the first match of this episode with a third different formation. This is getting ridiculous. Going with a 4-3-3 this time. Because I just can't find the groove. I can't find the mojo of this team. I can't find what something from this team to stand out. Hopefully, this will be the last time I have to play with this team, because if I win this match, then I and Sampdoria defeat... No. Yeah, Sampdoria need to beat Krasnodar. If that happens, then I and Sampdoria will both be guaranteed progression to the knockout stage. Now, when Gothenburg and Krasnodar played, Krasnodar won, which does get me a little worried that Krasnodar might be on good form for this match against Sampdoria. But it does mean that Gothenburg here are four straight losses. So hopefully I can make it five and mean I can skip the last game, which will be against Sampdoria. And while it will be for who finishes top of the group, I couldn't give a rat's backside. As long as I am safely through, I couldn't care whether I finish top or second. And second goes true as much as top does. So I could not give a crap. So yeah.
Marseille are on the move now. Shots on here.
Oof.
Referee points for a corner. A decent fist away by the keeper. And shoots over the top.
Oh, over the bar. So far, I've not noticed any great improvements. Well, they are playing a little bit better. Maybe 4-3-3 will work for this team. Who knows? I'm not going to get my hopes up. It's still early. But, Mastier, he's only got one defender to beat. He's got two players in support. Are you freaking kidding me? And then he puts it over the bar. Oh my god. Oh my actual god. I don't even believe in God, but I know he's trolling me. If he exists, he is trolling me. The FIFA God is definitely trolling me. Yeah, you pricks.
Good work by Marseille to get the ball back.
Pele to Rolando. Oh, that is an interesting pass, isn't it?
Oh, it goes across.
Pele to a guy whose name is almost the exact same as Ronaldo. Not something you'd expect to hear, is it? Unless you're playing Ultimate Team, of course. In case you could have Pelé and Ronaldo on the same team. You'd be very dominant, probably.
That's good support as they build this
attack. He's made it with his head. Hey! Yes, it's no side!
Scoring on your debut.
Dungu, who scores his second Europa League.
I haven't seen him.
He go. Oh. Which definitely means it's when I saw. My new striker in January. I will be selling money. There's dumbass back to Barcelona having failed. Dungu just assured that he will be sticking around. Oh! Oh, he almost scored again! How did the keeper keep that out? I might have actually scored a second goal in a Europa League match. Which would make up for not scoring at all in that Sampdoria game.
Reassessment shortly at half time. Paolo De Cecchi.
Oh, great save from the keeper, from the shot that came from my left back.
Jeje.
Los Campos. Put some pressure under the defense and they might make a mistake. Or they'll concede the throw. Go, 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 go.
Jeje.
Alessandrini, he won't get there.
From this position, they can maybe work something more significant in front of goal from the throw. Silva.
Los Campos.
Goes for goal with the
header. Oh, just wide. I think it was Meunier. Mastier. I think it was Mastier with the header. What's the scoreline in your match? Come on, Krasnodar. Krasnodar nil, Sampdoria nil. That's not good enough. I need Sampdoria to score. Well, that result would mean I go top. That doesn't guarantee me progression because Krasnodar will still technically be able to catch me. He with two games left.
Sonnenriks, now he's got the ball back. Paolo De Cecchi.
Dungu, surely not a second. He pulls it back for Silva, who shrugs off a challenge. Goes for it! Over the bar!
Wasn't it just everybody in the stadium thought that.
Yo, I think I found the formation. This is much better from this team. They're actually playing good. They're not getting the goals, but their performances are much better. That is filthy referee. Yellow card.
It's a bad one. Yellow.
No question about it.
And the goalkeeper's won it. Right behind the
master. They're just ignored. Hurt the ball and just let it fly overhead. I mean, no. You think he'd header it to try and
he's kept the ball.
Make it harder for the keepers? If and maybe he caused the second goal? No.
He's cut out that pass. It wasn't an accident. He read the mind of the opponent.
Silva again. Mastier.
Cross coming in now. The ball deserved,
Los Campos is beaten to the ball, but it might be it's a throw. I wasn't sure where it was going out for a throw or corner. Which is why I didn't say anything up until I was sure where it was going.
Well,
Murrow. Dungu! He ignored the ball! He didn't take it! It rolled right past you! You're having such a good game. Don't bring your performance down, mate. Don't do that to yourself.
For the home side, oof. Their next game in League One.
Oof. I'm still... we're going to be signing your man, so you're going to be... need to get your performances up to match a near A-rated play. Here's if you're going to have any more say in this... here's Europa League competition.
Well, they kept up the pressure, didn't they? But it's finally been stopped now. Check there with the cross.
Santorini doesn't win the header. Or apparently he did. It's because it's a goal kick. Rolando. Ocampos, go! That time Alessandrini damn sure didn't win the header.
Good work by Marseille to get
but my right back wins it back.
He can cross it now.
Somebody give me some goddamn options. Messier!
Well done the goalkeeper, and he's hung on to the ball. Time is very much the friend of Marseille in these circumstances.
It's looking like it's going to be another 1-0 win, but this is much different than the other 1-0 wins. Hang on! Don't go! 2-0, yes! It's happened! They actually did it!
His debut, wonderful stuff.
It.
We just feel sorry for Keita, really, the way he's hit that to his right.
2-0, the second team is actually capable of scoring more than one goal in a game.
Restarting at 2-0.
And it's that man again, Dungu. I know. Oh, I'm not saying his proper name. I'm probably pronouncing the name wrong anyway. But I can't pronounce whatever the hell his actual third name is. So I'm gonna call him the Goo. Whatever his name is, he's guaranteed me. There's no question that I'll be going through now. Oh, regardless of the Sampdoria match, Krasnodar could have beaten them. Man, it's not gonna matter.
The
fans are delirious because they've witnessed his Marseille history. It was 1-1. Krasnodar can still mathematically catch me. I think.
Fiorentina.
Was that? Was that game 4 or was that game 5?
West Ham United 1. Bordeaux 0. Villarreal.
And all the excitement, and I'm not too sure. I'll have to check that.
Dortmund 1. Standard Liège 0.
It was game 4. Okay, so yes, they can still mathematically catch me. Look at that. There we go. There it is. Mathematically, they can still catch me. But with that goal difference and with that sweet second goal. Oh. It's weird that it took me until game 4 to get on top of the group. Oop. But surely, mathematically, yes, it's still possible for them to catch me. But mathematically, my backside, it isn't gonna happen. And I would have to lose to both Krasnodar and Sampdoria. Yeah. For even it to be a remote possibility. And yes, the matches will be sent because I have the utmost confidence that the job is done. Whew. And it's quite fitting who my next opponent is because I do feel very nice. Yes, I know it said Nice. But I speak English. I don't pronounce words French style, which is why I call Emery Chan Emery Can, because there is no H in his name, and they literally spell Nice N-I-E-C-E.
Alan, we're looking here at the side with the best defensive stats so far in Marseille.
And I think what makes this team so hard to beat is...
Oh, that's a dirty foul. 2 minutes in and you're already in the book, number six.
It's yellow, and the referee shows
that guy's
early mercy here.
Holy shit, this guy's named Siri.
Have to be careful with these challenges. Hey.
I should take advantage of this and ask him questions. Annoy the hell out of him and confuse him.
And the goalkeeper hangs on.
I put the ball on a plate and no one at their dinner.
That will be a throw for Marseille. Benjamin Mendy. Well, they've got a corner out of that. A bit lucky. It was deflected.
Well, I'll take the corner. Hopefully, serving up seconds. I will stop with the food analogy now.
And the header is a
Diarra. He hit one last episode.
Cleared it well.
So, he's on a hot streak. As is Van der Wiel. He scored in the last episode as well. And what was his 13th game since joining Marseille from PSG?
Yeah, and I think sometimes with the
he finally got that first goal in a Marseille shirt.
And it might mean they have to change halfway through this match.
Throw with a bit of urgency about it to keep the attack going.
No options for the throw. Careful. Good defensive work. By which I mean that they didn't concede a penalty, and the defender cleared it using his head. Quite literally using his head.
And he's up for the header.
Tovan almost used his head to score.
He's got it away, and that's what you have to do. Oh, in goes the cross. Danger was looming large. They've got themselves back on the ball, and they can attack themselves now.
Going all the way back to the keeper, very dangerous.
The danger.
Come on, win the header. Yes.
He's moved in, trying to jostle the
opponent. Çalhanoğlu, Tovan, Bashawayi, whip it in. Enkidu, he didn't even jump for it.
Marseille's throw.
I'll take the throw, but I mean, come on, is it too much to ask for your players to jump for headers? There's when you cross the ball in. Oh! Tovan, he didn't even need to jump to win that header. But the ball came to him, and he wins another corner. Oh, yes! Yes, it's in! I think it's an own goal! Oh. It might be a record second goal because he scored in the last episode as well, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be an own goal for their number 24. Ironic, considering it was my number 24 who won the corner. It is an own goal for her number 24, Bodmer, their captain. Oh my god. Cruel, cruel irony. He strikes me. I'm sure they're gonna be devastated.
That will be a throw for Marseille.
Now they have to be the first team to score against me this career mode, which still hasn't happened yet. I know it is gonna happen eventually. It's just a question of who is it gonna be? Which team will break my defensive streak, so to speak.
That's very good positional
play. Oh wow, that was a terrible pass.
Read the situation perfectly with that interception.
Oh wait, Diarra wins it back. And then another terrible pass. Brilliant. He did win it back, but he ran straight out of play with it.
Wasted no time at all. Mendy. Home or away. A massive run that they're on and just want to keep it going today.
Well, you look throughout the side and it's full of top class performance.
A kick.
All the players just exuding confidence.
Ashwai. Chalago. If he can win the battle, oh, the defender did enough to stop Chalago breaking away with the ball. This is their time. Well, with 4 added minutes, not sure where the 4 added minutes came from.
Crosses in, cross towards Fletcher.
Yes! Oh no, he's offside, yes! Stephen Fletcher doubles the lead just before halftime.
And what a volley it was. Wasn't too far away, but
and Lady of Luck is not smiling on Nice today.
Very well taken.
Hey, because it is 2-0, a very cruel own goal, and a very sneaky second goal. Oh, puts them behind the 8-ball. Oh. Proverbially.
Restarting at 2-0.
A double header of disappointments to end the first half. If you're Nice. If you're a Marseille fan, you are loving life. And is it the same old song and dance as the previous games?
Well, the rain
goals in the first half, with
Matt, relentless.
Pretty much nothing in the second. Except maybe a few good saves.
Ben Arthur. It's a real
and on the occasion, one extra goal. I'm sure Nice would hope that there's at least two, maybe three more goals in this match, but it would want them to be for them.
The counter-attack there.
Oh, Chalago gives it to Bashaway. Oh! It's still not gone though.
He's put that into his own net.
It is 3-0. Oh, I think the referee would have given a penalty anyway. Hey, for the foul on Chalago. With.
Caught in an awkward position, the player there.
The end there.
Up, deflecting the ball into his own net.
Yeah, maybe just didn't adjust his feet quickly enough. A little clumsy.
Or, no? He was oh no, it's another own goal! It's been given as another own goal! These are not getting any luck in the defense today. 2 own goals? I thought it was a Chalago goal. That must have been why it was like a little pause or some shit. I should have known it was an own goal.
But to do it with an own goal,
I didn't see the deflection off of number 20 over there. Or that would warrant it being an own goal, but I'm going to trust the game's decision to give it as an own goal. As I don't know why I hit it with Fletcher going for glory. As he scored the, as he snaked it in the own, he goal scored by one of my own players in this game.
There is some backup for him in this position.
Past his man there.
He's got his shot off now.
And the wheel, off the bar. Fletcher. Lavener crack at the cross.
Stop the cross. That's what he's
come to Tovan. Chalago. Vanderweel.
Got in the way of that block.
Oh, if only handballs were on. Because that very clearly hit the defender's hand.
Fixture. Marseille, they'll be facing Saint-Étienne away from home.
Yeah, it's an important tie for both sides. 3 points at stake.
It's out for a throw. Very exciting episode. But if I do say so myself, Chalaglu whips it in. Tovan over the bar. Brilliant. And can do.
The cross coming in.
Puts it in. Flash away. Makes it four. Actually scored two goals in the second half. It all the history is being made in this career mode today.
Seemed to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way out. Well, it was a striker's instinct there because there wasn't a lot of.
Is Bash away? There's
another angle on it here.
There's a goal. Unless the game wants to give that as an own goal for the keeper. I think it's going to be a Bashawai goal. Yes, it is. So the Strike Force have gotten a goal between them. Paired with two own goals from two very unlucky
Ben Arfa.
He needs defenders.
Well, got away from him. Oh, he's through.
Shawai.
Got it away, and that's what you have to do.
That will be trying to set up a possible fifth there. Imagine if I score a fifth, then technically there would have been three goals in the second half, and none of them would have been for Nice, even though one of them was scored by a Nice player. Oh, to be honest, I don't know where Nice are in the table, but
just lent it to his teammate for a moment.
If you told them that they would have been involved in if I forgot whole match with the league leaders, players would score two goals. And their defenders would score two goals. Well, they would probably take it. Not realizing what they'd be taking, but it wouldn't. I don't know if they'd be able with pieced two and two to get better, her to get 4-0. Because in this case, I don't think it's gonna. I don't think a fifth goal is gonna come unless Nice can get a consolation goal, which, to be honest, I almost feel like they deserve a consolation goal. The bad luck they've gotten, but they're not gonna get it, especially not with Ben Arfa taking shots like that. That was a pretty bad shot.
You never know in the remaining minutes, he might just have to be on his toes. He's got to keep his concentration.
It's out for a throw. Referee should blow the whistle any second now. No? Still no full-time whistle. It's only 2 minutes. There it is.
Performance here from the winners.
The job is done. Another victory. 4-0. Oh, against a very unlucky Nice. The own goal was really. He must have soured. It's this game. Although, if it had been 2-0, I don't think Nice would have had a fucking good time.
Liga.
Although, it would have been better if they had lost 2-0. Oh, and there had been no own goals.
So, what do those results mean to the
that's just
at the top of the table remains
kind of logical. Maybe I'm thinking about that wrong.
32 points. In third, Paris Saint-Germain with 29 points.
In any event,
Stade Rennais with 27 points. In fifth, Bordeaux.
Yes, Bashawai, you were right. Sixth,
climbing the table are
so
18 points.
The next seventh, game.
Lorient with 18 points.
Ooh, the next game. Oh, I'm looking forward to the next game, because the next game, the first game of the next episode, tomorrow's episode, will be against second place Saint-Étienne.
Toulouse with 10 points. Fifth bottom, Stade de Reims with 11 points.
I already beat PSG out of second place. If I beat Saint-Étienne, chances are PSG, well, it'll depend on the score lines between PSG and Saint-Étienne. There needs to be a 6-goal overturn for PSG to go up into second, to retake second. So I might not knock Saint-Étienne. Ignore all those. Those are some of the players I'm looking at for the second team. And yes, I'm still going to improve the second team. Of course I am. But, yeah, in the next episode, yeah, I'll clear those off camera, because that'll take a few minutes. I'll take a few seconds, and I don't keep you for longer than I have to. So, do not miss the next episode where I take on Saint-Étienne and Monaco, because I'll be simming that game against Krasnodar, because unless there's an unlikely turnaround, they are not going to catch me. So, I'll be playing the teams in second, and at the time of recording this, 6th, because looking at Lorient, they could go lower, or if results go against Monaco in the game before they play me. Saint-Étienne will be looking to close the gap. I will be looking for a gap of 10 points. So don't miss tomorrow's episode. Also, if you enjoyed this episode, smash the like button and subscribe so you don't miss tomorrow's episode or any future videos from myself. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace!